out. Sometimes you are certainly not alone. A lot of people deal with it. A little bit of stress is a normal part of everyday life, though.
When it comes, though, to when it becomes chronic, when stress does, it can actually cause big problems on the mind and the body. And did you know about 1/3 of adults say stress levels affect the way they feel?
Dr. Partha Nandi joins us right now with more on this important health issue. So, Dr. Nandi, how does psychological stress make a person physically ill?
So, Carolyn, you know, the answer may really lie in a special cell that's involved in the body's immune response. It's called the mast cell. We know that these mast cells are involved in fighting off physical allergens from the body. They also play a key role in diseases like asthma, irritable bowel syndrome, and lupus. But we're learning now that psychological strain is also linked to increased activity in mast cells. Researchers have actually learned that these cells create a peptide called CRF1 that's critically involved in causing both physical and psychological disease. So scientists hope that by targeting these mast cells, they may soon be able to find new ways of treating stress-related ailments.
Wow, I know there are plenty of other ways to get sick this winter. Certainly nobody needs stress to contribute to it, but you've always got prescriptions for us. So what is your advice for people who want to keep their cortisol levels under control and avoid getting sick this winter?
Absolutely do, Joanne. So keeping the cortisol under wraps is one of the most important things you can do for your overall health, and there's some simple ways to do this. So first of all, please set aside some time in your day to consciously unwind. We live in a very stressful world, as you know, and it's important to take a step back, take a deep breath sometimes, and I think that that would be important. Also, practice mindfulness in everyday situations. Stress often comes from thinking too much about the future, and diffuse it by staying in the moment. Also, consider taking up yoga or meditation practice. I love both of them. Both are excellent ways to train your brain to stay more present. Also, if stress is making you physically ill, this is important. Please see your doctor. We can give medication that can be helpful in the short term.
Wow, good to know. Okay, so what are some of the physical symptoms of too much stress? How do we really know?
So, Carolyn, lots of common physical ailments can be stress-related. So we have fatigue, muscle soreness, headaches, and insomnia, just to name a few. But there are subtler symptoms that can be brought on by stress, like depression, anxiety, lack of motivation. And that's why staying mindful and finding ways to keep stress at bay is so important. It can affect your overall health.
Well, Dr. Nandi, we appreciate you as always for your medical advice. We certainly listen and we certainly take notes.
My pleasure.
Enjoy the rest of your day.
Yeah.